सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्य कृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिः शान्तिः शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति स्मि तगुंह देवमात्मविद्युत्प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेशानमोहयं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धिर्वृतं पारं सर्वेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेव अन्नमत्वनिर्ति मे निश्चितामतिः। Comparing Swapna with Jagrat Avastha, in order to compare Swapna with Jagrat Avastha, Swapna is established as Mithya, but due to a valid reason, with a proper Tarka. And in the Tippana, the last part, we saw that Swamiji says in the Tippana that there are different opinions as to technically who is the adhisthana of Swapna, or what is the adhisthana of Swapna Jagat, who is the adhisthana of Swapna Drashta. Basically, what exactly in each of the Triputi has its adhisthana as during Swapna. So we saw Paramarthika, Vyavaharika and Pratibhasika Jiva definitions, and thereby who is the or what becomes the adhisthana in general. But then Jada cannot be adhisthana, Chetana has to be adhisthana, and that Chetana happens to be one. So whether you call it as Sakshi Chaitanya or Brahma Chaitanya, it is Chaitanya. Whether it is Jiva Sakshi or Ishvara Sakshi, that Chaitanya is one. And that is the real adhisthana in any case, in any avastha, for any padartha. This is the idea which has been conveyed, and thereby samanvaya has been done. Now, Trivida Satta Pakshi Vilakshanayor Jagraswapnayor Satta Bheda Vastutaha Tayoho Availakshanyat Satta Aikyam Eva. These three jivas were mentioned by different sattas: Paramarthika Satta, Vyavaharika Satta, and Pratibhasika Satta. These are the three sattas we generally know. But in reality, there is only one satta, because satta by itself means reality. You cannot have multiple realities. Tattvam has to be one. There cannot be multiple tattvas. Tattva is tasya bhavaha. Tasya kasya bhavaha. Kasya api. You take anything, its status, its reality has to be one. There cannot be multiple realities. In fact, Tat is a Sarvanama. Elsewhere, Bhagavan Bhashyakara analyzes that Tattvam Asi, there Tat. Tat is a Sarvanama. In that sense, in Sarvanama sense, you know, when it comes to the analysis of reality, then Tat is seen as a Sarvanama which stands for Sarva. So Sarvanamas includes all namas. This is how we analyze this. Although Sarvanama is a sanya, but still Tat includes everything. Being a Sarvanama, it includes Sarva. So Tasya Bhavaha Tattvam will mean Sarvasya Bhavaha or Sarvesham Bhavaha Tattvam. That is how the meaning of reality comes about for the word tattva. So reality has to be one. It cannot be satta trividyam. So that is analyzed here as to how can there be one satta when trivida satta is being talked about. And it is not by any other darshana. It is talked about by your own darshana, Advaita darshana itself. Vedanta Panchadashi, Vedanta Paribhasha, all of these talk about Satta Trividyam. So where do you get this Satta Aikyam? This is the thinking of the Purva Paksha that is seen here. Trivida Satta Pakshe Vilakshana Yoho Jagrata Swapna Yoho Satta Bhedaha. So Jagrata Avastha is Vyavaharika, Vyavahariki Satta, and Swapna Avastha is, Swapna Avastha has, Jagrata Avastha has Vyavaharika Satta, Swapna Avastha has Pratibhasika Satta, and they are Vilakshana, Vilakshana Sattas. Paramarthika Satta is Brahma Satta, which is separate. So Satta Bheda is there. Vastutaha, in reality though, Tattvataha Vastutaha, Tayoho, Ayavailakshanyat. There is no Vailakshanyam in them, among them. Therefore, Sattaikyam. Now this is the Pratijna. How is it so? There is a Shankha raised. Brahma Chaitanya Tatra Shanka, Brahma Chaitanyasya Swapnadishthanatve Brahma Jnana Mantra Swapno Nanivarteta iti Shanka. So in this Trivida Satta Paksha, if you say that Brahma Chaitanya is the Adishthana for everything, including Swapna, so Swapna Adishthanam Kim? Brahma Chaitanyam. If you say that, then Brahma Jnana Mantra Swapnaha Nanivarteta iti Shanka. Because whenever there is some bhranti, that bhranti is due to avidya, ajnana of what? Ajnana is not generic. It is an ajnana of some particular thing. So what is it here? It is this adhishthana. So adhishthana ajnana causes the adhyasa. Therefore adhishthana ajnana will take away the adhyasa. This is a niyama, general rule. Here Swapna Adhishthana is Brahma Chaitanya. When will Swapna resolve? Swapna as Adhyasa will resolve only when Brahma Chaitanya Adhishthana Jnana takes place. Therefore Brahma Jnana Mantara Swapnaha Na Nivarteta Iti Shanka. Dvitiya Paksha, this has been analyzed a bit in the Tippana, but in the Moola we will see how it is treated. Dvitiya Pakshe Brahma Chaitanyam Swapnasya Adhishthanam Iti Avidya Upadhanam Iti Cha Uktam. So in the second Paksha, there are two options given as to how to see this. What is it, Dvitiya Paksha here? You go back to the Moola. Dvitiya Pakshe Brahma Chaitanyam Swapna Adhishthanam. Prathama Pakshe Adhya Pakshe Sakshi Chaitanyam Swapna Adhishthanam. What is Upadhana Karana? Upadhana Karana is either Antakkarana, where Sakshi Chaitanya is a Swapnadishthana, or Sakshad Avidya Ajnana Eva Upadana Karana, where Brahma Chaitanya is Swapnadishthana. So in the second case, what do you have? Dvitiya Pakshe, Brahma Chaitanyam Swapnasya Adishthanam Iti Avidya Upadanam Iti Cha Uktam. Avidya is Upadana Karana and Brahma Chaitanya is Adishthana. For what? For Swapna. Adhishthana Jnana Mantara Kalpitam Na Nivarteta Swapna Adhishthanam Cha Brahma. Swapna is Kalpita and without the Adhishthana Jnana Kalpita Vastu won't go away. So Swapna won't go away. Swapna Adhishthanam Cha Brahma. Therefore Brahma Jnana Mantara Tasmat Brahma Jnana Mantara Ajnaninaha Jagrata Avasthayam Swapnaha Na Nivarteta. Ajnani will never wake up. Why? Because Swapna will continue to be there. Swapna cannot go even in Jagrata Avastha. What is Jagrata Avastha? Where you don't have Swapna Darshana. So Swapna will not go unless Ajnani becomes a Jnani. That is not the case. So this is the Shanka. Jagrat Swapna Yoho Brahmadishthanakatve Ubhavapi Vyavaharikau Syatam Athava Ubhavapi Pratibhasakau Syatam Iti Shanka. Then there is further issue with the Siddhantis. Ekasatta and this Brahma Chaitanya being. Finally, with Brahma Chaitanya being talked about, Ekasatta is going to be talked about. So when you say Brahma Chaitanya is the Adhishthana and that is the reality, everything else is Mithya, then you are close to establishing Ekasatta. However, there is a flaw. There is another flaw. One flaw has already been pointed out, as there won't be an ajnani in Jagrat Avastha. Jagrat Avastha, only jnanis can be there, because Swapna won't go away without Brahma Jnana. Now, another problem here is that your Satta, which you have accepted right now as three types, you cannot have Vyavaharika Satta or you cannot have Pratibhasika Satta. Why so? Because Swapna and Jagrat Avastha, both having Brahma as Adhishthana, what is the difference between the two? There is no difference. Then Swapna will have the same Satta of Jagrat Avastha, which is Vyavahariki Satta, or Jagrat Avastha will have Swapna Satta, which is Pratibhasiki Satta. Therefore, Jagrat and Swapna both will become either Vyavahariki, Vyavaharika Satta, or both will have Pratibhasika Satta. Yatha Swapnasya Adhishtanam Brahma Upadhanam Chavidya, Tathayo Vedanta Siddhante Jagrati Vyavaharika Padarthanam Api Adhishtanam Brahma. Just like you have said that right now, you have said that Swapna Adhishtana is Brahma and Upadhana is Avidya. Similarly, in Vedanta Siddhanta, what is it? In your own Siddhanta, says the Purva Pakshi, Jagrat Avastha also has Vyavaharika Padarthas, which have Adhishtana as Brahma and Upadhana as Avidya. That is the same case everywhere in both the Avasthas now. If you say that Swapna Avastha also has Brahma as Adhishtana and Avidya as Upadhana Karana, just like Jagrat Avastha, there is no difference between the two. Actually, Ishtapatti. We want the Purva Pakshi to say that and we say it is true. However, technically, there has to be some analysis done. Tatra Jagrat Padarthaha Vyavaharika Iti, Swapna Padarthaha Pratibhasika Iti, Chakathyante. But you have said that Jagrat Avastha Padarthas are Vyavaharika and then Swapna Padarthas are Pratibhasika. Having said that, you cannot say that both have Brahma as Adhishthana and Avidya as Upadana Karana. Otherwise, both will become same. This is the Purva Paksha. What is the difference between the two? Esha Vedha na bhavitum arhati. Kayoho Vedha Swapna Jagrat Avastha in the Avasthas. Swapna Jagrat Jagratoho Vedha na bhavitum arhati. This difference cannot be established at all. Ubhayor api adhishthanam brahmayo bhavati upadhanam cha avidyayo bhavati tasma jagrata swapnayor ubhayor api vyavaharika satta vyavaharikata aur vyavaharika satta bhavitum arhati athava ubhayoho pratibhasika satta bhavitum arhati ubhayoho satta vaishamye nasti upavattihi. Now in fact the text is such that in the title itself titles are long enough to tell you what exactly is being talked about. Some details are there, so there is a repetition. So we can go faster in such less complicated places. So what is the answer to that? What is the difference between Swapna Avastha and Jagrat Avastha? Purvokta Shankayoho Samadhanam. Both the Shankas are going to be resolved. First one is that Brahma Chaitanya Mantara Jagrat Avastha Na Sambhavati Swapna Na Nivarteta. Here, second point, second shanka is that there is no difference between Jagrat and Swapna because both have same Adhishthana and same Upadana Karana also. Brahma Jnana Vina Api Swapna Nivritti Pradarshanam. How will Swapna go away without Brahma Jnana? It can. That is shown here. Tatra Prathama Shankayaha Samadhanam Evam Bhavati Nivrittir Dvidha Iti Purvam Chaturthat Tarange Khyati Nirupana Prasange Uktam. It was mentioned in the earlier chapter as to Nivritti is of two types. One type of Nivritti that you talk of, which is Atyantiki Nivritti, that won't go away. Siddhanti agrees. Swapna does not go away forever. Because the next day also there is Swapna. Next sleep moment there is a Swapna. So Swapna Nivritti is not Atyantiki. We are not talking about Atyantiki Nivritti. Atyantiki Nivritti is there only after Brahma Jnana, that is a fact. But Laya Rupa Nivritti is possible. Vilaya Rupa Nivritti is possible. That is possible. Why? By taking away Nidra Dosha. which has been mentioned earlier. In another manner, it was mentioned. So, Nivritti Dvidha iti cha, iti purvam chaturthattarange khyati nirupana prasange uktam. What are these two Nivrittis? Karana sahita karya vinasha roopa atyantika Nivritti sapnasya jagradavasthayam brahmajnanamantara na sambhavati. We agree to Purvapakshi's opinion that karana sahita karya vinasha roopa atyantika Nivritti. Atyantika Nivritti has karya vinasha, also karana vinasha. Karana sahita karya vinasha is there in atyantika Nivritti. That won't take place in Sopna Nivritti. Sopna Nivritti is Laya Rupa Nivritti. Parantu Danda Praharena Yatha Ghatasya Mrityikayan Layo Bhavati. Tatha Sopna Hetu Bhuta Nidra Rupa Dosha Nashadva Sopna Virodha Jagradavasthotpatya Va Avidyayam Laya Rupa Nivritti Hi Sopnasya Brahmajnanam Vinapi Sambhavet. But it is still possible to have Sopna Laya. How does that take place? Just like Danda Praharena Ghatasya Mrityikayam Layaha Yatha Bhavati Tatha. How the Ghata, Ghata Nasha is what? It is Ghata Nivritti. Ghata is broken by continuous hammering by Danda. That time Ghata will finally become Churna. That Churna is what? Mrityika. So where did the Ghata go away? Ghata can still be recreated. So it has not completely gone away. It has gone away into Mrityika Avastha, Mrida Avastha. So Ghata is there, but it has gone to the Mrida Avastha, it has merged. Similarly, Swapna can get merged into Jagrada Avastha. Laya, it can become resolved into Jagrada Avastha. Tatha Swapna Hetu Bhuta Nidra Rupa Dosha Nashadva. Either by Nidra Rupa Dosha Nasha. This is a specific addition which was an upadhi given by the Siddhanti to differentiate between the two. Avidya plus Nidra Dosha is Sapna Avastha, whereas Avidya leads to Jagrada Avastha. So all Avasthas will have Avidya. Even the Sushupti Avastha has Avidya. But what is the specific addition, add-on in other avasthas? So here you see in Swapna Avastha there is an additional Nidra Dosha. So when Nidra Dosha Nasha takes place, that time there is Swapna Laya Rupa Nivritti or Swapna Virodhi Jagrada Avastha Utpatya. This is like Jnana coming up. So Jnana, either you look at the Jnana or Nidra Dosha Nivritti. Nidra Dosha goes away, Nasha of Nidra Dosha, or Jagrada Avastha Jnana, which is Swapna Virodhi Jagrada Avastha Utpatti. You know that you are the waker. You know that you are the same person who went to sleep. Then that Pratyabhijna is there. Slowly the Nidra goes away. And how does it go away? You wake up. The waking up is knowing the waking state that will counter this Swapna. Therefore, Swapna Virodha Jagrada Avastha Utpatyava Avidyayam Laya Rupa Nivrittihi Swapnasya Brahmajnana Vinapi Sambhavet. So, resolution is not really in Jagrada Avastha, because in the Prakriya, how is it explained? Karana Avidya is the Karana for both Jagrada Avastha and Swapna Avastha. So, the Nivritti will not be in Jagrada Avastha, the Nivritti will be in Avidya. So, Avidyayam Laya Rupa Nivritti Swapnasya. Swapna Nivritti is in Avidya by Laya in Avidya. That is possible without Brahmajnana also. This answers the first doubt. What about this question of Satta? There is Satta Bheda between Jagrata Avastha and Swapna Avastha. Vyavaharika Pratibhasi Kayoho Bheda Asti. But in your case it won't be possible because Brahma is Adhishthana in both cases and Avidya is Upadana in both cases. Doshantara Asahakruta Avidya Matra Janyam Vyavaharikam. Doshantara Sahakruta Avidya Janyam Pratibhasikam Iti Dvitiya Shanka Samadhanam. Already it has been hinted with Nidra Dosha. There is an additional Nidra Dosha in Pratibhasika. In Vyavaharika, there is only Avidya. So Dosha, दोषांतर इज नॉट अन्य दोष, अन्य दोष दोषांतरम. सो दोषांतर असहकृत विदाउट हैविंग अनदर दोष अविद्या मात्र जन्यम. वॉट इज ब्रॉट अबाउट ओनली बाय अविद्या, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज व्यावहारिकी सत्ता, दैट इज व्यावहारिकम. एंड दोषांतर सहकृत अन्य दोष सहित अविद्या जन्यम एंड बॉर्न आउट ऑफ अविद्या. वॉट इज एन अन्य दोष, निद्रा दोष, दैट इज प्रातिभासिकम. इति द्वितीय शंका समाधानम. इन स्वप्न केस इट इज निद्रा दोष, एल्सवेयर वी हैव टू लुक फॉर अदर दोषस. यदुक्तम जागृत स्वप्नौ समानौ इति. सो जागृत एंड स्वप्न अवस्था आर समान. दिस वाज द ऑब्जेक्शन. यदुक्तम सॉरी यदुक्तम जागृत स्वप्नौ समानौ इति तन्न, दैट इज नॉट ट्रू बिकॉज वी डू मेक भेद बिटवीन जागृत एंड स्वप्न अवस्था. जागृति देहादि पदार्थानां उत्पत्तौ दोषांतर असकृत केवल अविद्या उपादान कारणम. स्वप्न पदार्थानां उत्पत्तौ साधि निद्रादि दोष सहित अविद्या कारणम इति विशेष अस्ति. सो इन व्यावहारिक देयर इज ओनली अविद्या, इन प्रातिभासिक देयर इज अविद्या एंड सम दोष, निद्रादि दोष, निद्रा और सम अदर दोष. इन स्वप्न निद्रा, दैट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द टू. सो भेद विशेष इज देयर. तस्माद् अन्य दोष रहित केवल अविद्याजन्यम व्यावहारिकम, साधि दोष सहकृत अविद्याजन्यम प्रातिभासिकम. सो इट्स अ रिपीटेशन इन डेफिनेशन. स्वप्न पदार्थः निद्रा दोष सहकृत अविद्याजन्यत्वात् प्रातिभासिका भवन्ति. जागृत पदार्थः दोषांतर रहित केवल अविद्याजन्यत्वात् व्यावहारिका भवन्ति. सो दी स्वप्न पदार्थः आर व्यावहारिका बिकॉज दे हैव अन्य दोष आल्सो अलोंग विद अविद्या बैकिंग देम. एंड देन जागृत अवस्था पदार्थास आर जागृत पदार्थास आर ओनली अविद्याजन्य, देयरफॉर दे आर व्यावहारिक. इत्थं स्वप्न पदार्थानां जागृत पदार्थेभ्यो वैलक्षण्यं दृश्यते. इदं तु सर्वं सत्ता त्रैविध्यम् अंगीकृत्य स्थूल दृष्ट्या उक्तम्. सो इज अ ग्रॉसर पर्सपेक्टिव, अ जनरल पर्सपेक्टिव, taking into account that there are three sattas. So if you accept three sattas, this is the explanation given. But in Drishti Srishtivada, there are either two sattas or there is only one satta. There is Paramarthiki satta and Pratibhasiki satta, or there is only Pratibhasiki satta. There is no Vyavahariki satta separate at all in Drishti Srishtivada. But Srishti Drishtivada has three sattas, which is Stula Drishti. Stula Drishti is It's for Mandadikari, for Adhamadikaris. So what is being said here is based on Tattva Drishti's question, where three sattas are accepted by Vedantins also to explain to those sadhakas. So this answer is given that Nidra Dosha is additional, which will differentiate between Pratibhasika and Vyavaharika. Other than avidya, additional dosha is needed. Vicharyamane tu, however, if you do vichara, you look into this, you inquire into this. Vicharyamane tu satta traividyam na sangachyate. Jagra svapnayorapi parasparam vailakshanyamapi na siddhyati. So if you argue that, oh, differences won't be possible, but there are differences, then we'll explain the differences. If you say that there won't be differences, I don't care if there are no differences. So tell me whether there are differences, meaning there are differences leading to three sattas, or there are no differences leading to only two sattas or one satta. I am agreeable to both. If you explain, then we will teach the Drishti Srishti Prakriya. If you keep on objecting, no, it is not possible. How can you, how can you say that Ishvara Srishti is same as Jiva Srishti? It's blasphemy. Okay, it is blasphemy, so we'll teach you Srishti Drishtivada. This is the Vedanti stance. And for masses, it is not possible to say that, oh, your parents are mithya, your spouse is mithya, your children are mithya, your wealth is mithya. Either they'll laugh out even in your face or they'll get hurt. Their feelings are hurt. So how can you say that, I'm struggling so much, my parents have done so much for me, my spouse has done so much for me, I love my children and you call them mithya, My Ishwara, what about my Ishwara? So Karmakandis and Upasakas who have Shraddha in that setup of three sattas, they don't want this Drishti Srishti Vada. So there this explanation is given that there is difference. So they are arguing, how do you make such Brahma as Adhishthana for both Swapna and Jagratavastha? So technically it also can be explained with Nidra Dosha being additional for Swapna and Laya is possible, Brahma Jnana Mantara. But if you inquire into it, then the Purva Pakshi's question is valid. That's why Ishtapatti, if he says that if there are no differences in Adhishthana and Upadana Karana for Swapna as well as Jagratavastha, then either Swapna becomes Jagratavastha or Jagratavastha becomes Swapna. We say yes, Jagratavastha becomes Swapna. Swapna will not become real. Because avidya krita, both are avidya krita, you are agreeing. So how can avidya krita make something real? So Vyavaharika and Pratibhasika are just names. Both have avidya as karana. Upadana karana is avidya. Thereby, jnana will give nivritti to both, and whatever goes away by jnana, whatever is nivritta or badhita by jnana, has badha by jnana, that cannot be said to have satta, its own satta. It is not real. Therefore, we don't care whether you differentiate between the two sattas or not. We say there is only one satta. There is no second satta at all. If at all second satta is there, that is the Bhranti Pradesha, Pratibhasiki satta. So, parasparam vailakshanyam api na siddhyati. Pramana granteshu. Now, the Purva Pakshi says, he is not ready for this teaching. Pramana granteshu satta trividyam uktam iti akshepaha. But your own Vedanta Pramanas, this is what the counter is from Vedantins. They say, oh, Bhashyakara does not say it. How do you know Bhashyakara does not say it? Some teacher told you one particular teaching, one particular reading, one particular method of reading tells you that. Bhagavan Bhashyakara's words are prasanna gambhira. They don't have only one interpretation. It is not plain translation. You pick up one book, read translation and done with it. That is not how it works. It is manana grantha. You have to think about it. If you are unable to think, then some hand-holding is done by tikakaras. Study multiple tikas. Inquire into the words. Then these words start to talk to you. They reveal the ideas which are there in Bhagavan Bhashyakara's mind, which is there from the Shruti, because he is, Bhashya is not limited to one Shruti. He is forced to put it into that particular context. So that limitation is there, but still there is a lot within those words. And that is brought out by tikas and multiple granthas, which are based on Bhashyas, which are independent Prakarna granthas, but built over Bhashyas, across the board, across the Upanishads, or Brahma Sutras and Gita also, across Prasthanatraya. Or you look into the Prakarna Granthas created by Bhagavan Bhashyakara. There you will see all these ideas where he does not have any limitation of the context. He makes his own context. There you will see all these ideas presented. So, Pramana Granthishu Satta Trividyam Uktam Iti Akshepaha. This is what the Purva Pakshi says now. Your Vedanta Granthas do not talk about it. They talk about three sattas. Vedanta Paribhasha Adi Granthishu Purva Uktaritya Vyavaharika Pratibhasika Padarthayor Vedo Nirupitaha. There is a difference between Vyavaharika and Pratibhasika Satta as per Vedanta Paribhasha also. And several other Granthas. Not only Vedanta Paribhasha, other Vedanta Granthas, Advaita Vedanta Granthas themselves agree that there is difference between Vyavaharika and Pratibhasika Padarthas. Tasmat Taihi Sattatrayavidyam Angikritam. and Parmarthika Satta anyway is there only for Brahma. So they have accepted the three sattas. Tatha eva Vidyaranya Swami Bhirapi Satta Traividyam Abhyupetam. Even Panchadashikara agrees with Satta Traividyam. Evam hi Tairuktam Dehadi Padartha Dviprakaraha Bahya Abhyantarascha iti. What does Bhagavan Vidyaranya Swami say? He says that there are three sattas. Now this is in one Grantha. Those who have no idea of what Vidyaranya Swamiji talked about elsewhere, they don't know any other possibility also being there. In fact, Bhagavan Vidyaranyacharya has said that Drishti Srishti Vada is like a Chauradwara to Raja. There are people who are waiting to visit the king, and there are crowds and crowds. The king is not available to everyone all the time because he has other work to do. Now, the praja wants access to the king. They have to come in a queue in a particular time. But there is a spy who is appointed by the Raja himself who has the access, a shortest access through a Chauradwara. He can go and meet the king any time of the day or night when he wants to meet. So like that, shortest path, avoiding all the intricacies, all the check posts, this spy has access to the king. Similarly, is the access of a sadhaka who is well prepared. He has access to Brahma Tattva through Chauradwara, which is Drishti Srishti Vada. So in modern language, it's a hack into the system. You don't have to go through all sorts of things. There is a hack. There is a back door. Programmatically. Why do you care as to how do I reach the goal? There are multiple ways available. One who can take the shortest path, he also reaches the same goal as one who takes the longer path. You prefer the longer path. You enjoy the ride. Go ahead. No, I like the picturesque view. Well, go ahead, enjoy the Srishti and then finally reach Brahma. Other says that I want to reach the king. Finally, I want to meet the king. I want to reach Brahma Tattva. I don't care. I don't enjoy this picturesque view. I don't care. Let it be there. But I am not hankering after the picturesque view. I'll let it go because my goal is important and I want it now. Then you cut the journey short. And it will work only if it is convincing. So it has to be Manana Siddha. So that has to be kept in mind because Vidyaranya Swami, what he says, that also has to be looked into in context. So there he talks about Ishvara Srishti and Jeeva Srishti. Tasma taihi satta traividyam angikritam tathaya Vidyaranya Swami bhirapi satta traividyam abhyupetam evam hi tair uktam dehadi padarthaha Dviprakaraha Bahya Abhyantarascha iti. So there are padarthas within and without. All these dehadi padarthas are there inside the mind also, outside the mind also. Outside the mind created by Ishvara, called as Ishvara Srishti. Inside the mind tainted by Ragadvesha, colored Ranj Rage. So with my Ragadvesha, when I see, hear, taste, there is my own subjective reality to these padarthas. These are created by me. So it is Jeeva Srishti. This is the differentiation. Tatra Ishvara Srishta Bahyaha Jeeva Sankalpa Krita Manomayaha Antaraha. Tatra Jeeva Sankalpa Rachitaha Manomayaha Antaraha Sakshibhasyaha Ishvara Srishta Bahyaha Pramatu Pramana Gocharaha. The Ishvara Srishta Padarthas have a Pramata and Pramana Vyavahara. The Ishvara Srishta Bahya Padarthas are Prameya. Pramata cognizes those through his Antakkarana and Indriyas, therefore Pramana Gocharaha. Whereas inner subjective reality. So if you like sweet, I do not like sweet. The sweet outside is created in the same manner. There is nothing as to additional attributes being there in the sweet. A particular padartha, you like it, I do not like it. Why? Because I have my own dvesha, you have your own raga towards the sweet. Ishvara has created that sweet in a particular manner. That padartha is Ishvara srishta. Ishvara srishta. The sweet maker is also Ishvara srishta. This everything is given. The sweet maker has just put them together. Sugar has been added. Where did the sugar come from? It came from sugar cane. Where did the sugar cane come from? The seed. Then the seed and the ankura. You have the seed tree issue. So you say that we don't know how it came about. Anadi kalena, it is there. Bhagavan has created it. Bhagavan has created a system that you sow a particular seed, you get some plant. You sow a mango seed, you won't get a sugar cane. So these differences are there. So Ishvara Srishta Padarthas are there outside, whereas the sweet that is created is same, or you take sugar cane itself, need not have. So sugar cane, I have trouble, I don't have teeth. So I have trouble eating sugar cane, I don't like it. No, I don't want sugar cane. Others, you know, they enjoy sugar cane, it trains their teeth, they exercise their teeth. So the others like it. So they have raga, I have dvesha. So in my mind, there is a different sugarcane. In your mind, there is a different sugarcane. But the sugarcane outside is the same. That sugarcane outside is pramata, pramana, gochara, padartha. Whereas in my mind and in your mind, there is manomaya, antara, sakshivhasya, jiva sankalpa rachita, sugarcane padartha. Antara manomaya dehadeha eva jivasya sukha dukkha hetu bhuta. I have dukkha with sugarcane because I have some inner thinking about sugarcane. That is the hetu for dukkha. Whereas for you, prasaswada is there, so that aswada that you have, that is due to your own thinking that there is value, you add value to that sugarcane. So you have raga, I have dvesha, that is sukha dukkha, sukha hetu for you, dukkha hetu for me. Bahyatu Ishvara Srishtana Sukha Dukkhadi Hetavaha. But the external padartha, Ishvara Srishta Padartha, is as is. It cannot be Sukha or Dukkha Hetu. Tasmad Antara Manomaya Padartha Nivruttaveva Mumukshuna Yatitavyam. Bahya Prapanchana Sukha Dukkha Hetu Ataha Tan Nivruttau Na Yatitavyam. Therefore, what should a sadhaka do? Sadhaka should, Mumukshu should take efforts for manomaya padartha nivrutti, jiva srishti nivrutti, not bahya prapancha nivrutti, not ishvara srishti nivrutti. Tathahi kayoschit dvayoho purushayo putro dhanarjanartham kadachit deshantaram jagmatu. There is a story here which is given as an example for this jiva srishti and ishvara srishti. We'll look at it in the next part. सुकनिच्छं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दुःखेत्तरं पारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव अहन्नमत्तोऽन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः. नमस्ते.